In this series, I'm reviewing a couple of common rookie mistakes in SOLIDWORKS and how you can avoid them. And today I'm talking about not using the origin in your first sketch of your model. So I'm going to start a sketch on the top plane and just make a simple rectangle shape, maybe add some dimensions to define its size. And what we'll notice is after I, you know, have added these constraints were added automatically, I've defined the size and shape of this rectangle, but not the position. And we can tell that because I can drag those points around and because SOLIDWORKS is telling me this is still underdefined. Now, we are working in the very first sketch of our model, so there's nothing for me to connect this to except the origin. That's the only reference point we have in 3D space right now. So something to keep in mind is that when we start our models in SOLIDWORKS, we are always working with these three reference planes, front, right, and top. Now, I'm sketching on the top plane of the model right now, but the intersection of those three planes is where the origin is formed. And that origin is really the only point we have to define that very first sketch in space. So I'll turn these off and bring that sketch back to normal. So right now, if I were to just leave the sketch off here in space, those reference planes don't really have any defined connection to my sketch or my model going forward. Instead, we want to connect it to the origin somehow. And one easy way is just going to be to take the corner of this rectangle and make it coincident with the origin. If we had drawn, you know, reference lines to the center of this rectangle or another corner, there's lots of different places that could be helpful and relevant. But I'd say the corner for now is a pretty safe bet. We'll go ahead and use this sketch for a feature and hit OK. Now, after we create that feature, we've made a solid body with selectable faces and edges and other entities that we can now use to define our future sketches in space. So let's say I started another sketch on the top of this plate. We'll do another rectangle and just give it a, you know, some basic dimensions. So now I don't have to keep referring back to the origin. Now I can utilize the existing model edges to help define this sketch in 3D space. Right. So after that initial sketch and feature, we have additional geometry to define ourselves with. We're not just restricted to using the origin. Now, another time when this comes in handy is when you're taking mass properties, when you need to look at like the center of mass. If we go and calculate the center of mass of this model now, these coordinates that are reported here, it says report coordinate values relative to the default. That means the default origin, which is wherever we left it in that very first sketch. I can turn on the visibility of our origin so that we can see it over here in blue. And that's going to be a helpful reference when we need to look at something like the center of mass, as opposed to just having that origin be somewhere off in space. So again, don't be a rookie and remember to use the origin in your very first sketch of your model, and it's going to save you time and confusion later down the line. And we'll see you in the next video tech tip.